إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we are coming upon the blessed day of Arafa, which this year would be Thursday, July 30th, which is tomorrow inshallah. And this is a blessed day, but to remind ourselves first and foremost of the benefits of that day and the days of Tashreeq, let us also remember what we are still in, this being the eighth day of Dhul Hijjah, and the day where the Hujjaj, the pilgrims, would be heading out to Mina. The first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are the best 10 days of the year, and good deeds more beloved to Allah than at any other time. That reward still stands. Let us not lose out on this time. An Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu, he narrated that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, أَفْضُلُ أَيَّامِ الدُّنْيَا الْعَشَرِ, that the best days in this world are the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he reported that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهِ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ. There are no days during which good deeds are more beloved by Allah than deeds done in these 10 days. In another narration, it adds, فَأَكْثَرُ مِنَ التَّهْلِيلِ وَالتَّكْبِيرِ وَالتَّحْمِيدِ, so make frequent tahleel, saying La ilaha illallah, takbir, saying Allahu Akbar, tahmeed, saying Alhamdulillah on these days. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in the Quran, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُ اسْمُ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ. Allah said what means in the Quran and Surah Al-Hajj, that they may witness benefits for themselves and mention the name of Allah on known days, on known appointed days. According to the Mufassireen, these are the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And just to continue on the point with respect to remembering Allah, also Allah said, وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَاتٍ, and remember Allah during the specific numbered days. This ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah refers to the days of Tashreeq, the 11th and 12th and 13th of Dhul Hijjah, which this year will equate to Saturday, August 1st, Sunday, August 2nd, and Monday, August 3rd, until the sun sets. These are from the days of Tashreeq, and we should know with respect to them that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, يوم عرفة ويوم النهر وأيام التشريق عيدنا أهل الإسلام وهي أيام أكل وشرب, that the day of Arafa and the day of sacrifice, يوم النحر, the day of Eid, and the days of Tashriq are Eid days, the 11th, 12th, and 13th of Dhul Hijjah, they are Eid days for us Muslims. They are days of eating and drinking rather than fasting. Of course, if you're not on Hajj, you fast Arafa. It is like an Eid for the Hujjaj. But the day of Nahr and the 3 days of Tashriq are Eid for those who are not on Hajj. So this Eid is 4 days, and we should not fast the 10th, 11th, 12th, or 13th of Dhul Hijjah. They are days of eating and drinking. And we have in another narration that's mentioned, Ayyam al-Tashriq, أيام أكل وشرب وذكر الله عز وجل, that the days of Tashriq are days of eating and drinking and dhikr of Allah, the mighty and the majestic. And this hadith is in Muslim and it's recorded in his Sahih. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, the takbir is of two types. The mutlaq takbir, which is what we should have been saying at all times, and we should continue to say at all times through the 13th of Dhul Hijjah until the sun sets. And then there's Takbir al-Muqayyad, which is the specific Takbir, which now will begin from many reports that we see after Fajr prayer on the day of Arafah, which is the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, which is equivalent with Thursday, July 30th this year, until Asr prayer on the last day of the days of Tashriq. And it was reported by Ibn Abi Shaybah in an authentic report that Ali radiallahu anhu kana yukabbar ba'da salat al-Fajr yawmi Arafah يوم عرفة إلى صلاة العصر من آخر أيام التشريق ويكبر بعد العصر. That Ali رضي الله عنه, and we have this report from many of the companions, that they would say takbir after Fajr prayer on the day of Arafah. So after all the 5 daily prayers now on Arafah, Eid, يوم النحر, and the 3 days of Tashriq, after each of the Fard prayers starting with Fajr prayer on the day of Arafah until after Asr prayer on the last day of Tashriq, until the sun sets, they would say takbir. And it would be said also after Asr. And this takbir, this glorifying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is for the men and the women. The men to raise their voices. As for the woman, she should raise her voice to the extent that she can hear herself and those surrounding her. But it should be a lower voice. And this is definitely, it should not be heard if there are non-mahram men around her. So this is from the specialities of starting on the day of Arafah. And my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is a venerated day with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the best days of the year. And if we look at what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said many things regarding this day. First of all, it was the day that the religion was completed. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. That our Prophet, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran in Surah Al-Ma'idah, he said, this day I have perfected for your religion for you and completed my favor upon you and have chosen for you al-Islam as your religion. This completing and perfection of the deen occurred on the day of Arafah. On the day of Arafah. It is also, as we mentioned, a day of Eid for the people who are at that place, for the people who are making the Hajj. The day of Arafah is an Eid for them. As we mentioned in the hadith we said a bit earlier. And also Allah, He swore by this day. And Allah does not swear by something that it is minor or has no significance. He can only swear by things which are mighty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in the Quran, والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود. Allah said in Surah Al-Buruj, what means by the heaven holding the big stars. So this is a swearing by it because it's a magnificent thing. واليوم الموعود, and by the promised day, this is the day of resurrection. The day of resurrection where we'll be all resurrected and be called to account. The day which is 50,000 years long. وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودٍ, and by the witnessing day. According to many of the Mufassireen, although there's some differences with it, the witnessing day is the day of Jum'ah, Friday. And by the witness day, this is the day of Arafah, Hajj, on the ninth day of Dhul-Hijjah. And we said, as we said, Al-Hajj Arafah. So Allah, He swore by these days because of its greatness. Because of its greatness. Now for those not on Hajj, fasting on this day is an expiation for 2 years. Abu Qatada radiallahu anhu, he mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Siyamu yawmi Arafah, inni ahtasibu ala Allah an yukaffir sanat allati qablahu wallati ba'dah. This hadith, which is sahih in the Sunan of Ibn Majah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the fasting of the day of Arafah, I have hope with Allah that He will forgive the sins of the previous year and the upcoming year. Of course, this doesn't mean we fast it so we say, oh, I fasted it so I can make all the sins I want in the next year. We should fear Allah with respect to this, my brothers and sisters in Islam, and know that this is generally for the minor sins and that the major sins require repentance. So this again is a venerated day. It is also the day on which Allah, He took a covenant from the progeny of Adam. He took the covenant, that Allah took the covenant from the loins of Adam, and He brought forth from his loins all of his offspring and spread them before him, and He addressed them. He addressed them at that time. أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ, am I not your Lord? And they all said yes, and we testified to it. Lest you should say on the day of resurrection, verily we were unaware of this. So all of us, all of Bani Adam, were taken from the loins of Adam and testified to Allah's oneness, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it is the day of forgiveness of sins and freedom from the fire and pride of the people who are going to, who are there. In Sahih Muslim, it was narrated from Aisha radiallahu anha, that it was narrated from Aisha radiallahu anha that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ما من يوم أكثر من أن يعتق الله فيه عبدا من النار من يوم عرفة وإنه ليدنو ثم يباهي بهم الملائكة فيقول ما أراد هؤلاء. It is the day where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, there is no day on which Allah frees more people from the hellfire than on this day of Arafah. He comes close and expresses his pride to the angels, and he boasts to the angels, what do these people want who are standing on the plain of Arafah? And it was narrated from Ibn Umar that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah expresses his pride to his angels at the time of Isha on the day of Arafah about the people of Arafah. And he says, look at my slaves who come unkempt and dusty. And this hadith is in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad and class Sahih by Sheikh Al-Albani. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, many of us may say, well, we're not there on that day. The scholars differed concerning the virtue of the day of Arafah, whether it applies only to those in Arafah or those in other places as well, who are not on Arafah, not on Hajj. So be mindful of this and listen. The most correct view is that it is a general meeting and that the virtue is connected to the day. But undoubtedly, those who are on Arafah, on the plain of Arafah and on Hajj, they have a combined virtue of being at the place and the virtue of the time being the day of Arafah. But there is still virtue for those who are not on Hajj and Arafah to do good deeds, to give in charity, to read from the Quran, to fast, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And listen to what Allah said, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. And this hadith is narrated by Ali and Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. And it's found in the Sahih of At-Tabarani, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, أَفْضُلُ مَا قُلْتُ أَنَا وَالنَّبِيُّونَ يَوْمَ عَرَفَةَ لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. The best thing, the Prophet ﷺ said, the best thing that I and other prophets have said on the day of Arafah is لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. The best thing that the Prophet ﷺ and the prophets have said is that there is no true God, there is no God worthy of worship except for Allah alone without any partners. To Him belongs the dominion and the complete praise, and He is capable of everything. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in a nutshell, this is the virtue of the day of Arafah, which is the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, and some of the virtues of the days of Tashreeq. The day of Nahr, the Eid day, is the greatest day of the whole year. This year will be Friday, the day of Eid, and we'll send out how to pray it at home and the likes because of the coronavirus restricting us from being able to pray it together. But that is the best day because it is the day that the pilgrims do most of their acts of ibadah on that day. It has the most acts done on it. And Abdullah ibn Qurt radiallahu anhu, he narrated that Allah's Messenger said, "Inna afdala aw a'zam al-ayyam 'inda Allah yawm an-nahr thumma yawm al-qarr." That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, indeed, the best or the greatest day before Allah in our year is the day of sacrifice, which is the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, the day of Eid, followed by the day of rest, which is the 11th of Dhul Hijjah. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we can see that we are upon some venerated days, very great days. Wet your tongue with the remembrance of Allah, especially on the day of Arafah. La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lahu, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir. Especially starting after every prayer, starting with Fajr on the day of Arafah, saying takbir after every fard prayer. It doesn't have to just be said three times. Some people just say it three. If you say it once, that's sufficient. But you can say it a lot, and we should be saying it a lot until the sun sets on the 13th of Dhul Hijjah at all times and after every fard prayer, starting after Fajr on the day of Arafah till after Asr on the last day of Tashreeq, which is the 13th of Dhul Hijjah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillah Alhamd. This is the takbir to wet your tongue with at all times and after the specific prayers. I pray to Allah that we are from those who get to witness the day of Arafah and live it fast to Allah, as we are not on Hajj this year, and be able to glorify Allah with the supplications we mentioned and with the takbir at all times and at specific times. And we get closer to Allah, and we are from those He frees from the hellfire. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, washhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.